Trying to stay on top of a vehicle segment in terms of sales is one of the hardest things for an automaker to achieve. Yet, the Honda Civic has remained at the top rankings for years in the compact cars class. True, Honda took its eye off the ball a few years ago and let the stalwart slip in terms of cabin quality and features, but the company quickly took care of those weak areas the following year. For 2015, however, the Honda Civic continues to be one of the top picks in a field packed with great contenders. So, let's go ahead and check out this 2015 Honda Civic. Now, our trim of the Civic we have here is the EX model. Now, it comes pretty loaded. The only things you really won't find on this trim here is navigation or leather or heated seats. But it comes pretty loaded overall. You do have Honda's Lane Watch system, as well as a touchscreen radio and all of the basic necessities that you find nowadays, like Bluetooth, streaming audio, as well as a rear view camera. Now, as far as styling goes on the Civic, it's pretty much kept the same form from when it debuted in the 2006 model year for the 8th generation Civic. And to be honest, it's getting a little stale here. You have these halogen headlights, but don't expect to find anything like projectors or even LEDs. And then they have made revisions to the exterior styling, but not much, to be honest. And then you also do have these 16-inch wheels that do give the Civic much more visual appeal here on this EX trim. Now here goes the key fob for the vehicle. Love the key fob for the Civic. Very high quality looking here. You have your lock, unlock to release your trunk, and then your panic button. Now it is a silver exterior color with smart key access on the driver's door, as well as the front passenger door. Gray cloth interior, manual driver's seat adjustments. Now, when you step on into the Civic here, you're greeted with a pretty stylish cabin design overall. Step in height is fairly low here, has good ease of ingress and egress. But the only thing that really bothers me is that they kind of kept the same basic design since the 8th generation debuted. Now, don't get me wrong, they have made many revisions over the years, like this nice stitch portion that they debuted in 2013. And then they also made more soft touch materials too. And then you have this touchscreen radio. But the basic overall design of it is still the same from when the 8th generation debuted in 06. But if it ain't broke, don't fix it, right? Now you do have push button ignition. Just put your foot on the brake and hit the button to start, of course. And what you're hearing is a 1.8 liter 4-cylinder. Now coming to your transmission, you have a CVT automatic. Putting the vehicle into reverse displays your rear view camera, of course, with guidance lines. And you have trajectory as well, which you really don't find on compact cars. And I'm going to go ahead and turn on the lights and the hazards too. And let's go ahead and pop up the hood and check out the engine bay. Heated exterior mirrors. Halogen headlights. Now under the hood here you have a 1.8 liter 4-cylinder, which is your base powertrain, producing 143 horses and 129 pound-feet of torque, with the EPA estimates being a pretty good 30 in the city and 39 on the highway. I bet it probably bothers Honda that they weren't able to hit the 40 mark. Now, you do have a 5-speed manual as your base transmission, and then you can get the optional CVT automatic we have here. And then also, you have the availability of a 6-speed manual with the 2.4 liter 4-cylinder that comes on the SI model of the Civic. Overall, this powertrain is very refined. It'll get the job done, be reliable to you for many years to come. Now, trims of the Civic start at the LX, which starts at $18,290. The EX starts at $20,390. Then the EXL starts at $22,640. And then if you want navigation in that EXL, you're looking at $24,140. Now, the LX comes well equipped with many features on the Civic, including a rear view camera, standard Bluetooth, and a Pandora radio interface. Now, competitors of the Civic, you have the vehicles in the compact car class. This includes its arch enemy, the Toyota Corolla. You also do have the Ford Focus, Chevrolet Cruze, Volkswagen Jetta, Nissan Sentra, Mazda 3, and the Subaru Impreza. It's a very, very crowded class. And you also do have the Dodge Dart as well. Rear window defroster, rear reflectors. Like I said, EPA estimates are 30 in the city, 39 on the highway. Total vehicle price for this particular one is $21,980. Of course, the Civic comes equipped with all of your basic power necessities, power windows, door locks, and power exterior mirrors. Nice soft touch cloth armrest. And let's go ahead and rev it up. Now, as far as build quality and materials go inside of the Civic here, it's pretty average for the class. You have decent materials up here on the dashboard, pretty padded, and then it also has this nice molded stitched portion. Pretty nice there. And then also on this upper door panel here. Build quality is okay, but it's not the best I've seen in the class. It's definitely not like how it once was back in the 90s, but it's still average for the class. It's still decent. Now, coming to the steering wheel design, I love the steering wheel design of the Civic. I really like this black trim going surrounding the buttons, and then this trim right here too. And then it's just a lot of contrast. I love it. Makes it look very stylish and premium. You have your voice recognition right here, Bluetooth hands-free calling, steering wheel mounted audio controls, and then this button right here controls your little information center up there, which I will get to in just a second. And then coming over here, you have your cruise control buttons, of course. Down there you have a manually tilting and telescoping steering wheel. Decent range of adjustment. Down there you have your cup holders. E-brake is also located right here. And then down there is where you will find your USB port. Okay amount of center console storage. Down there you have a little storage cubby right here. HDMI port, USB port, and then a 12-volt power outlet. And then right there, you also do have another little storage compartment. And then coming up here, you have a manually dimming rearview mirror. Sunroof with your sunroof controls. Now coming to the main center stack controls here. Pretty easy to figure out for your air conditioning. Just press on, and then you have your fan speeds right here. Front window defroster, rear window defroster. Different modes. Pretty easy to figure out. And then coming to the main head unit here, you have this touchscreen radio, which it works fairly well. The responsiveness of it is pretty good overall. You have your phone right there, Bluetooth hands-free, and then you could store some of your contacts on there. It gives you your speed dial and then your call history too. And then when you click on home button, that reveals pretty much everything. You have your info right here, which gives you your instant and average fuel economy data, then your history of your trip. Then your radio, AM, FM, CD player too on this bad boy. Satellite radio is also an option. And then coming to settings, you could change many different settings like the camera system, Bluetooth, any of those settings. And then you also do have Honda Link, which you can access various apps such as Pandora or AHA Radio through your smartphone data connection. But overall, the responsiveness of the touchscreen is really good. The user friendliness is superb as well. And it's actually a lot better than what you would find on the more larger Honda Accord or even the Honda Odyssey with the two-screen design. This is much more simpler and easy to use. But one gripe I do have about this system is the volume button. I wish they would just put a regular button or knob just to, you know, change the volume. I don't know why they have to make this touch sensitive. And then the responsiveness of this is actually pretty poor, I have to say. It's not as good as the regular touchscreen. But overall, I really do like this system. Now, coming to the gauges and instrument cluster, you have this eyebrow design, which Honda introduced this on the Civic in the 06 model year. Now, you do have the RPM gauge right there. Now, it looks, even today, decently futuristic, I have to say. You also do have a digital speedometer up there, and then your fuel gauge, and then your fuel economy. Now, like I said, this little screen right here is your information center. And like I said, it's all controlled by this little button right here. Gives you your time and what date it is, and then what radio station you're on, and your average fuel economy, your range, and then your trip odometer, exterior temperature readout, many different things that it shows. But basically, it's like a little mini head unit. Coming over here, you have your traction control off button, and then your econ mode. Now, one feature I really do love about the Civic is Honda's lane watch system. Now, when you signal to the right, a display of the camera on the side mirror right there will display on the screen. And then it's basically a blind spot camera instead of a blind spot monitoring system, and it works very well here. Now, you can access the camera anytime you want to by pressing on the button on the stock right here. But one gripe I do have is that I wish they did have a camera on this mirror over here. But it's a very cool, useful feature, and that feature is found on the EX model and above. Now, as far as the seats go, the seats are quite firm, I have to say. They do provide a decent amount of support. However, there's not a lot of cushion or padding to them. They're very, very firm here. Thigh support is decent, however. But overall, they're not the most comfortable seats I've tested out in a compact car. Now, as far as visibility goes, visibility is excellent. Lots of glass area all around here. Outward visibility is also pretty good, too. And then seeing out of the back is also good, too. And then, at least, you do have a rear-view camera standard on every Civic. Now, the Honda Civic has long been one of the better driving vehicles in its class, and this tradition continues with very precise and well-weighted steering, as well as composed handling. The Civic also offers one of the most comfortable and composed rides in its class, as well as low levels of noise at freeway speeds. Power from the 1.8-liter engine we have here is a little underwhelming, but its high fuel efficiency and typically refined character nevertheless make it a winner. Performance of the CVT is commendable as it swiftly downshifts when you need quick acceleration, unlike some other CVTs that seem to produce more noise than action. Overall, I think that just about all Civic buyers will be happy with the CVT's operation, and you can expect slower acceleration from the Civic Hybrid, though obviously efficiency is the overriding priority. Now, the Civic Si, as expected, is certainly the most fun to drive. Refined suspension tuning, quick steering, snappy acceleration, and one of the slickest, easiest to drive manual transmission around give the Si a sharp and playful attitude around town or on curving roads. Alright, and let's go ahead and shut down the Civic. Let's go ahead and check out the rest of the vehicle, including the rear seat passenger space, as well as the trunk capacity. Now, build quality and materials do follow through in the rear. Still a nice soft touch cloth armrest, but hard touch up here on the upper door panel. Now, sitting back here, the Civic has an average amount of rear seat leg space. Headroom is okay, however. Single mat pocket back here, and then a rear armrest with cup holders. And the seats are fairly comfortable, and they're more padded even more than the front seats. And I actually kind of like sitting back here more than sitting up here in the front. And usually I don't find that in a vehicle where I like to sit in the rear seats more than the front seats. All right. Now, trunk space is okay, but if you do get the hybrid, it will be much more limited. Now, these rear seats also do fold down, 60-40 split. But overall, it's a decent amount of trunk space here. Full manual passenger seat. Glove box compartment. Slams right down. I'm actually surprised it's not damped. Alrighty. So the Honda Civic may not be as automatic a choice as it once was due to improved competition, but its variety of configurations, high fuel economy, and ease of ownership keep it among the best compact sedans and coupes. So remember that this is Cameron Birch from Cameron's Car Reviews.